Childhood. I must have been about 7 when my father left Porbandar for Rajkot to become a member of the Rajasthanic court. There I was put into a primary school. And I can well recollect those days, including the names and other particulars of the teachers who taught me. As at Porbandar, so here, there is hardly anything to note about my studies. I could have been only a mediocre student. From this school I went to the suburban school and thence to the high school. Having already reached my 12th year, I do not remember having ever told a lie. During this short period, either to my teachers or to my schoolmates, I used to be very shy and avoided all company. My books and my lessons were my sole companions. To be at school at the stroke of the hour and to run back home as soon as the school closed, that was my daily habit. I literally ran back, because I could not bear to talk to anybody. I was even afraid lest anyone should poke fun at me. There is an incident which occurred at the examination during my first year at the high school and which is worth recording. Mr. Giles, the educational inspector, had come on a visit of inspection. He had set us 5 words to write as a spelling exercise. One of the words was kettle. I had misspelt it. The teacher tried to prompt me with the point of his boot, but I would not be prompted. It was beyond me to see that he wanted me to copy the spelling from my neighbor's slate. For I had thought that the teacher was there to supervise us against copying. The result was that all the boys, except myself, were found to have spelt every word correctly. Only I had been stupid. The teacher tried later to bring this stupidity home to me, but without effect. I never could learn the art of copying. Yet the incident did not in the least diminish my respect for my teacher. I was by nature blind to the faults of elders. Later I came to know of many other failings of this teacher. But my regard for him remained the same. For I had learned to carry out the orders of elders, not to scan their actions. 2 other incidents belonging to the same period have always clung to my memory. As a rule, I had a distaste for any reading beyond my school books. The daily lessons had to be done, because I disliked being taken to task by my teacher as much as I disliked deceiving him. Therefore, I would do the lessons, but often without my mind in them. Thus, when even the lessons could not be done properly, there was of course no question of any extra reading. But somehow my eyes fell on a book purchased by my father. It was Shravana Pitribhakti Natika, a play about Shravana devotion to his parents. I read it with intense interest. There came to our place about the same time itinerant showman. One of the pictures I was shown was of Shravana carrying, by means of slings fitted for his shoulders, his blind parents on a pilgrimage. The book and the picture left an indelible impression on my mind. "Here is an example for you to copy," I said to myself. The agonized lament of the parents over Shravana's death is still fresh in my memory. The melting tune moved me deeply, and I played it on a concertina which my father had purchased for me. There was a similar incident connected with another play. Just about this time, I had secured my father's permission to see a play performed by a certain dramatic company. This play, Harish Chandra, captured my heart. I could never be tired of seeing it. But how often should I be permitted to go? It haunted me, and I must have acted Harish Chandra to myself times without number. Why should not all be truthful like Harish Chandra? Was the question I asked myself day and night. To follow truth and to go through all the ordeals Harish Chandra went through was the one ideal it inspired in me. I literally believed in the story of Harish Chandra. The thought of it all often made me weep. My common sense tells me today that Harish Chandra could not have been a historical character. Still both Harish Chandra and Shravana are living realities for me. And I am sure I should be moved as before if I were to read those plays again today.